Chambara. Origin. Better safe than sorry. My name is Aya. I use the sword skills my father taught me to hunt undead all across Japan. The undead are reanimated human corpses. They devour the flesh of the living and run rampant throughout the world. Not that I give a damn about the world. 2 years ago, my stepmother was killed, and my father and half-sister Saki vanished. So I started looking for them, and one day, I was contacted by an informant named Rei. She said she'd help me find my family, if, in exchange, I would help her hunt the undead. A long time has passed since I started destroying the undead for Rei. But we still haven't found any solid leads. Just as I was almost ready to give up, exhausted by day after day of hunting, I suddenly received a message from Saki.
Aya, die, won't you? For Mom's sake?
Saki. Get out of my way. My blade's losing its edge. Time to shake off the blood.
We're all going down!
You are.
like that's the last of them.
Your friendly informant right here. So, you're at the graveyard? How's the quest to find your sister going?
Well, just like you said, I found Mother's grave. But her body's been taken away.
Whoa, taken away? What for, do you think?
Not sure. Maybe Saki wants to bring her back to life?
Are you kidding? That sounds like something out of a fantasy novel.
I guess. Anyway, got anything for me?
Oh, yeah! So, that little sister you're trying so hard to find? We may have a lead on her.
What?
Not far from where you are now. There's a hospital that was closed up years ago. Someone saw a girl in a school uniform in there.
Got it. I'll head right over.
I knew you'd be up for it, Aya. The abandoned hospital's in this direction.
Sounds good. In.
Looks like there's a barrier, huh? You should be good to go after clearing out all the undead here.
Fine by me. I was gonna take them all out anyway.
Nothing scares you in the slightest, does it? By the way, I had a peek at your phone and saw that message from your sister.
Another one of your stealth operations, huh? And what of it?
Well, I was shocked. I mean,
she taught me this.
Who talks like that to their sister? So, does your little sister have a grudge against you or what?
Who knows? After all, we're practically strangers.
Really? How come?
Well, for one thing, we have different mothers. Tell me my birth mother died
right after I was born. Wow, your family's pretty complicated.
You can say that.
I've got sisters too. I guess we get along all right, but sisters can be a real pain, you know?
I guess so.
I mean, really, we'd be better off without him, right?
But I get the feeling if I keep trying to stop him, she might lead me to my father.
Maybe.
For now!
Yeah.
I'm gonna slice you up. Whoa, you're a big freak, aren't you? Get in my way and I'll cut you in two.
My info says there's a large undead man on the rampage in the area. He overswings a lot and his attacks offer openings, but be careful. He's powerful. But knowing you, it's nothing you can't handle.
Well, that's pretty vague. But thanks. I'll dice him up real good.
Too busy to talk right now?
Whatever gave you that idea?
Poof, starting to get a little rough, is it? Your baneful blood gets excited when you're covered in the blood of others, doesn't it? And when that excitement reaches its peak, it makes you go berserk, right?
Here it comes. Yes! Now we're having fun!
Those of the Bandit Bloodline are even scarier than the undead. They really are fascinating.
It's over now!
Yeah.
You're a big freak, aren't you? Get in my way and I'll cut you in two.
My info says there's a large undead man on the rampage in the area. He overswings a lot and his attacks offer openings, but be careful. He's powerful. But knowing you, it's nothing you can't handle.
Well, that's pretty vague. But thanks. I'll dice him up real good.
Starting to get a little rough, is it? Your baneful blood gets excited when you're covered in the blood of others, doesn't it? And when that excitement reaches its peak, it makes you go berserk, right?
Here it comes. Yes! Now we're having fun!
Those of the baneful bloodline are even scarier than the undead. They really are fascinating.
It's finished, Ray.
Woof! Well done. Oh, by the way, Aya, I just installed a shop app on your device. You can use it to order items at any time. Of course, it'll cost money, though.
Yeah. Thanks, Ray.
You're welcome. looks like you're there.
A goddess statue.
Aya, are you religious?
Not really. I don't like this. It's too quiet. This elevator is stopped on the third floor. I guess it's broken. Oh, you must be the welcoming party. My father taught me when I was little. I guess I just do it because I want to. That's the only reason I need.
I see, so you just kind of do whatever feels right? Yeah. I get it. That makes sense. We've never known a world without the undead in it. Seems like the perfect place for people like you and Neon.
Maybe. Still, it's kind of hard to tell people you're in the undead business.
Still on. I'm looking at the building's blueprint. Oh, I see another elevator in the X-ray lab.
I'll head on over.
Yeah.
this must be it. It's not locked. I want to use that elevator, but getting to it won't be easy. There's some weird undead thing there. It looks sticky. No, more like muddy.
Muddy?
Oh!
You're talking about a type of undead called a mudman. They're kind of a pain. You can't kill them by just attacking them. Anyway, come on. Later. To damage the mudmen in your berserk form. That's not something I can test myself, though.
over now!
Took care of them all. Nice work. Apparently, that hospital was run by an organization known as Ouroboros. They were doing some kind of unethical research, and an accident destroyed the place.
Whoa. Is that why there are so many undead here?
Well, it's been a while, so I guess anything could have happened since then, right?